Welcome to machine learning tutorial. In this video, we will understand what is gradient descent and the delta rule and how to derive delta rule. First, we will understand what is linearly separable and non-linearly separable data. If the given data points can be separated with the help of straight line, such a data is called as linearly separable data. In this case, the data points, six data points are given to us. Three are positive and three are negative. With a straight line, we can divide this data into two parts. Hence, it is called as linearly separable data. In this case, we have been given six data points, three are positive and three are negative, but we are not able to draw a straight line to separate this data into two parts. Hence, it is called as non-linearly separable data. The perceptron rule finds a successful weight vector when the training examples are linearly separable, but it can fail to converge if the examples are not linearly separable. In the previous video, I have discussed how can we apply the perceptron rule for the linearly separable data. The link for the video is given in the description below. As we cannot apply perceptron rule to the non-linearly separable data, there should be some rule which can be used to separate a non-linearly separable data into different classes. Here comes the delta rule. The delta rule can be used to overcome the difficulty of perceptron rule. If the training examples are not linearly separable, the delta rule converges towards the best fit approximation to the target concept. The key idea behind the delta rule is to use gradient descent to search through the hypothesis of possible weight vectors to find the weights that fit the training examples. So in this case, we will start with a set of weights. We will apply the delta rule and we will try to reduce the error in the hypothesis with the training examples. And finally, we come up with one weight vector which has the minimum error between the hypothesis and the training examples. This rule is important because gradient descent provides the basis for the backpropagation algorithm, which can learn network with many interconnected units. It is also important because the gradient descent can serve as the basis for learning algorithms that must search through the hypothesis containing many different types of continuously parameterized hypotheses. This is a simple example how the delta rule works. This is the plane where we have the set of all possible weights. Initially, we will start with some weights. We will get some error. Later, we need to modify these particular weights in such a way that we go on reducing this particular error. Once we get the least error, those are the final weights. This can be shown with one more diagram like this. Initially, we will get some error with the help of initial weights. We will modify those particular weights with the help of a delta rule so that we can reduce the error between the hypothesis and the training examples. The same thing will be repeated unless and until we will get the least error. After a certain period of time, the error starts increasing if you go on modifying the weights. So this will become the clear winner here, which is having the least error in this case. Now the question is how to find or how to modify these particular weights so that we will get the least error between the hypothesis and the training examples. The delta training rule is best understood by considering the task of training an unthresholded perceptron, that is a linear unit for which the output of O is given by just a linear combination of weights and the inputs. We don't consider the threshold to get the output here. This can also be written like the output of vector x is equivalent to vector w dot vector x here. Thus, the linear unit corresponds to the first stage of a perceptron without a threshold. In order to derive the weight learning rule, that is the delta rule, for the linear units, let us begin by specifying the measure for training error of hypothesis relative to the training examples. Although there are many ways to define this error, one common measure is the error with respect to weight vector is always equivalent to half of the squared error between the target output minus the actual output taken over all the training examples. This is the error which is used to find the delta role in this case. Now the question is, how can we calculate the direction of steepest descent along the error surface? This can be obtained by taking the derivative of error with respect to each component of the vector W. This derivative is also called as the gradient of E with respect to vector W. That is, the gradient E with respect to vector W is equivalent to delta E divided by delta W0, delta E divided by delta W1, dot 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 delta E divided by delta Wn in this case. Since the gradient specifies the direction of steepest increase of E, the training rule for the gradient descent is vector W is always equivalent to vector W plus delta vector W. Delta vector W is equivalent to minus n gradient of E with respect to vector W. Here n is the positive constant called as the learning rate, which determines the step size in the gradient descent search, which can be set to a small number in the range of 0 to 1. The negative sign is present because we want to move the weight vector in the direction that decreases the E. Hence, we are using minus in this case. This can also be written like Wi is equivalent to Wi plus delta Wi, because vector W is nothing but W1, W2, W3 till Wn. So it can be written in the form of I also. And delta Wi is equivalent to minus n. This gradient of E with respect to vector W is delta E divided by delta Wi, because gradient of E with respect to vector W is known as delta E divided by delta Wi, W0, delta E divided by delta W1, delta E divided by delta Wn. So in general, we can write it as delta E divided by delta Wi. Now, how to get the value of this particular the derivative term? So that we will try to understand. We know that the value of E, or can say that the error with respect to vector W, is 1 divided by 2 summation of TD minus OD bracket square divide over all the training examples. We will put this thing in the derivative, that is delta E divided by delta Wi is equivalent to delta divided by delta Wi 1 by 2 summation of TD minus OD bracket square D belongs to. Now, if we take the derivation of this term with respect to Wi, first we will take 1 by 2 outside, and then the derivation of TD minus OD bracket square is equivalent to 2 times TD minus OD delta TD minus OD with respect to Wi. Now, we know that TD is a constant, that is the target output, but OD is the actual output, what we are going to calculate with respect to weights. Hence, this is not a constant, and the output is always equivalent to, it's a linear combination between weight vector and the input vector. Hence, it can be written like vector W dot vector XD, because it is with respect to dth example. One more thing is, TD is a constant. If you take the derivation of TD with respect to Wi, it will become 0. The second thing is, W vector is nothing but W1, W2, W3 till Wn here. And if you take the derivation of W1 with respect to Wi, it is 0. So 0 multiplied by XD is also 0. Similarly, W2, W3, all of them are 0 except when it becomes Wi. The derivation of Wi with respect to Wi is 1, and this term will become XID here. So the derivation of this term is 1 whenever W vector is equivalent to Wi. In all other cases, it is equivalent to 0. So the derivation of this term is minus XID. So that I have been written over here. We know that delta Wi is equivalent to minus n delta E divided by delta Wi. Delta E divided by delta Wi we have already calculated here. So delta wi will become this minus, and this minus will get cancelled, and summation of td minus od multiplied by xid. Finally, the weights are modified with respect to wi is equal to wi plus delta wi, where delta wi is equal to n into summation of td minus od with respect to all training examples multiplied by xid. In this equation, we know that what is the learning rate, what is the target, what is the output with respect to dth example, and we know the input also. So when you know all these particular things, we can put it over here to get the modified weights here. So this is the final equation to find out the modified weights for the given problem definition. So in this video, I have explained what is gradient descent, what is the delta rule, and how we have derived that particular delta rule. I hope the concept is clear. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.